So what we're going to do today is we're going to annotate a poem, and we're going to particularly emphasize three things. One, definitions. It's like specific background for parts of the poem, so maybe particular words that mean something different in the context at that time. Then it can also be general background about the author, about the time period, etc. And three, the favorite of every English teacher ever wrote, we're going to annotate devices. And specifically, we're going to annotate it with a few towards seeking some deeper meaning. So not just like what's at the surface, but using the annotations to really understand what's going on behind the first initial letters. Great. Any questions? What type of punctuation that we have?
Semicolon.
Why is the semicolon important?
Because it reflects like a continuation of connected ideas. So yeah. If the first sentence is connected to the second, yes. Then the form follows form.
Exactly. So when you have one form, imagine if you had a period. Maybe you could get it, but it makes a lot more sense when you say, hey look, this undone semicolon, your mind thinks, oh, I have a semicolon, therefore these two phrases are related, therefore in the bottom phrase, I can fill that in using information from the first phrase. So in order to fit the meter, because Shakespeare always cares about the form and fit the sonnet form. He needs to elide, he needs to omit, he needs to leave out some crucial grammatical elements. But he makes the reader do some of the work, so he doesn't have to, because he's a bit lazy, or a bit of a genius, depending on how you put both. Exactly. And he does that by using the commas, by using the meter, by using the parallel construction. I forgot I left that out, but if. And by using the semicolon. Right? Great. Why? What is annotation? And why do we do it? In one sentence.
We did it.
Where?
No, so annotation, what it is,
and why do we do it? One sentence.
It's it's actively, it's active reading, which involves writing down notes
and
underlining certain phrases, perhaps. To try and make sense of the poetic decisions that are being made, and to clarify certain things, like definitions, understand how background comes in, clarify rhyme structure.
Long
sentence. Yeah,
sorry,
sentence
in
paragraph.
Try this on.
Just had a bunch of
semicolons. Try this on for a bit.
Deeper.
Say marginal notes that give us deeper understanding.
With all
far more concession.
Yeah, marginal notes that give us deeper understanding. I mean, that's how
I would say all of this is part of the deeper versions of annotation.
So, it's like this. I say A-N-N. I say, oh! I say T-A-T-E. You say Tate. I say A-N-N. You say, oh! I say T-A-T-E. You say
Tate.
I say A-N-N, you say?
Oh.
I say T-A-T-E.
Tate.
What's that spell?
Annotate.
Why do we do it?
Because of that.
Deeper meaning.
And how do we do it? Marginal notes.
Alright, okay. Marginal, let's do this.
Okay, let's try that again. We'll do it a couple of times, okay?
Oh, I'm so pumped. This will be
let's go. Alright, so, A-N-N.
Oh.
T-A-T-E.
Tate.
A-N-N.
Oh.
T-A-T-E.
Tate.
A-N-N.
Oh.
T-A-T-E.
Tate.
What does that spell?
Annotate.
Why do we do it?
Deeper meaning.
How do we do it?
Marginal.